You are watching Storytellers in Motion.
The following program may contain scenes of violence, nudity, and objectionable language. Viewer discretion is advised. Cover Grandma's ears and send the kids outside.
Today we bring you the stories of Jim Compton. After 25 years in the business, Jim Compton still hasn't gotten tired of the chase, or as some storytellers like to call it, the bug.
Somebody shot of this here. This guy's looking at this rock here.
Going for the shot and making sure you've got it all covered is all in a day's work.
Okay, we'll see if they go in. If they go in, then we'll follow them. Okay. Otherwise, we got that stuff from Jeremy there. Just an idea, you know? Yeah. There's two sites. Hey, this is one. We'll go out to Sango. Two on the bus, and then come back for the ribbon cutting.
You can feel the adrenaline rush.
And then we'll go for the pouring after.
When you cover a live event on the fly.
We got lots here. How much should we shoot there?
48 minutes.
Wow.
Visual storytelling is an art form that requires a good eye to capture details others may not seem to notice. Jim was trained by some of the best in the business. He became a storyteller during the evolution of a radical Indigenous voice in the 1970s.
Brandon University was where I went and met some Native writers, Native professors that were teaching. I met a writer by the name of Hayami O. Storm, who wrote a book called Seven Arrows, and I was just totally intrigued with this guy. And he said, you know, you're a good writer. He says, why don't you, expand yourself and go down to a place called the Institute for American Indian Arts in Santa Fe, New Mexico. The thing that intrigued me there was that they had a film program. And, some of the best filmmakers, they were teaching there and they were talking about their films and, you know, how they got their films done and everything else. So that's when I got the bug. I thought, you know, I think that's really what I want to do. And I eventually came back to Canada. It's too expensive in the States. Took my journalism here in Winnipeg at Red River Community College.
A career as a print and magazine journalist was interrupted when Jim found out that CBC was offering career opportunities for cultural minorities. Jim Compton applied for a job and later became a familiar face to Winnipeg viewers.
Good job, boys. Good job. Good job. Yeah.